Welcome once again. Let's continue 18th century political formation. In the previous video, we were discussing about old Mughal provinces and we have discussed about Awadh in detail. Now let's discuss Bengal. Dear students, now how the Bengal became independent? So first of all, the Mughal Emperor Farrukhsiyar had appointed Murshid Quli Khan as the governor of Bengal in 1717. After some time, he himself independent of Mughal Empire. So Murshid Quli Khan was appointed by Farrukhsiyar as a governor of Bengal and he became independent. How he became independent and what he did, that we will discuss later on. After his death in 1739, Ali Varghese Khan, he became the governor of Bengal. And during the period of Ali Varghese Khan, the Bengal became a prosperous kingdom. He controlled the revenue of the state. He made several changes in the revenue collection system. Revenue was strictly collected from Jamindars. Here you can notice that during the Mughal period, the right of revenue collection, that was not given to Jamindar, but he gave the right of revenue collection to the Jamindars. So now Jamindar had to take loan from Mahajans and bankers. So during his rule, Jagat Seth, the banker community became very rich and powerful. So dear students, now you know the meaning of Jamindars and Jagirdars. The meaning of Jagirdar is the person who hold land. So during the reign of Ali Varghese Khan, the Jagat Seth, they became powerful because the Jamindar had to take loan from these bankers. Now students, third state was Hyderabad. So the founder of Hyderabad, Nizam-ul-Mulk, known as Asif Jah, played an important role in overthrowing Syed brothers in 1722 AD. As a result of it, he had been made the governor of Deccan, but he began to act like an independent ruler and laid the foundation of Asif Jahi dynasty. So Nizam-ul-Mulk Asif Jah, he was the founder of Hyderabad. He made Hyderabad an independent state. So now what were the policies of Asif Jah? What he did to strengthen his position? He brought skilled soldiers and administrators from the north. He made them Mansabdar and gave them Jagir. Now here meaning of Jagir is piece of land, and Mansabdar was a official who hold a post or a rank in Mughal court. So he appointed, he brought Mansabdar from the north and gave them Jagirs. In this way, he strengthened his position. Under his rule, Mughal emperor was nominal head who gave only confirmation to the decision made by Nizam. So it means Nizam, he became independent, and Mughal emperor, he became nominal head or puppet in the hands of these subedar or these governor of the independent states. Nizam's ambition was to control rich textile producing areas. So he was in struggle with Marathas and Nayaks of Karnataka. His ambition was destroyed by Britishes. So this is about Hyderabad. Now students, next category is the seizing powers. Among these, Sikhs of Punjab, they were in continuous struggle with Mughals. So after the death of Aurangzeb, they became powerful. So let's discuss about the Sikhs. So during Babur's reign, Guru Nanak founded the Sikhism. It was some sort of new religion. It was started by Guru Nanak. And in 1606, Arjun Dev put into death by Jahangir. And in 1675, Guru Tegh Bahadur tortured to death by Aurangzeb. So dear students, these torture and execution of the Sikh gurus, they greatly angered the Sikhs. So in this way, the relations between the Sikhs and Mughals, they became bitter. In 1699, Guru Gobind Singh founded Khalsa to defend the Sikh community and from the oppression. After the death of Guru Gobind Singh, 1708, Banda Bahadur challenged the Mughal authority, and in 1715, Banda was arrested and killed in 1760. So dear students, after the death of Guru Gobind Singh, Banda Bahadur, he became the leader of the Sikhs, and by the middle of 18th century, Guru Maharaja Ranjit Singh, he became the ruler of the Punjab, and he made his capital, made Lahore his capital. So he became very powerful. Now, next is seizing kingdoms. These were Marathas. Next category was Marathas. So the Maratha kingdom rose under Shivaji, 1627 to 1680. Shivaji established a stable kingdom with the help of powerful warrior family Deshmukhs. So Deshmukh, they were very helpful to the Shivaji. They helped Shivaji in strengthening the Maratha empire. So Maratha peasant warrior Kunbi, they became the base of Maratha kingdom. Shivaji nominated a council of 8 ministers called Ashtapradhan. In Ashtapradhan, there were council of 8 ministers who advised Shivaji in various administrative affairs. So the Peshwa was the most important minister. Peshwa means prime minister or chief minister. He was the most important minister of Shivaji. After Shivaji's death, Peshwa led the Maratha empire to its zenith. Maratha charged 2 types of taxes from the people living in the Mughal lands. So these were the Chauth and Sar Deshmukhi. So Chauth was 1/4 of the revenue and Sar Deshmukhi was 1/10 of the revenue. So this was the system of revenue collection of Marathas, and day by day after the death of Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb, they became independent and powerful. Now next category is of Jats. Dear students, this Jat community, that was very powerful community. So Badal Singh organized a Jat, established an independent kingdom. Badal Singh organized the Jats and he established independent kingdom. After him, his son-in-law Surajmal extended his authority over the large area from Agra to vicinity of Delhi. So the Jat area that fell between the Agra and Delhi. So he made Bharatpur as the capital of kingdom. So their capital was Bharatpur, and Jat built a garden palace at Deep. Jat territory extended further under the leadership of Chuda. So dear students, these Jats, they were very powerful, and they not only acted as independent kingdom, but during the time of later Mughal periods, they also provided a sort of help to the Mughal ruler. It is written that during the attack of Nadir Shah, they provided military support to the Mughal rulers. So students, these were the 3 types of states. Now the Vatanjagis. Vatanjagis were the categories. These were the group of, these were the states which were earlier under the Mughal rulers. They were allotted Jagis by Mughals, but they enjoyed, they were under the Mughal control, but they enjoyed autonomy during Mughal period. So how they became independent? So after the death of Aurangzeb, Jodhpur and Jaipur came to play an important role in politics of India. So these 2 Rajput principalities, Jodhpur and Jaipur, they became independent and they play an important role in the politics of India. The Maharaja of Jodhpur and Jaipur added to their possession a large portion of the empire during the regime of later Mughals. Jaisingh II of Jaipur was appointed as a governor of Surat and subsequently of Agra as well. So these The governors, they extended their powers. They also captured the neighboring provinces and became strong. Ajit Singh remained the governor of Ajmer and Gujarat. Besides holding their own kingdoms in full sovereignty, the territory from Agra to Surat in their hands helped these two Rajput kings to make their kingdom strong and prosperous. Rajput Raja Jai Singh made Jaipur his capital. So students, now in this chapter, you have noticed that after the death of Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb, the Mughal Empire that divided into several independent kingdoms, and the categories of these independent kingdoms, as I had told you earlier, were the old Mughal provinces and Watan Jagirs, Marathas, Sikhs and Jats. So you have studied these all three independent regional states in detail. So I hope you have understood this chapter. So students, it is a very important chapter, and you should read your NCERT textbook also. So to sum up, we can say that India in 18th century had to endure one of the most chaotic periods in its entire history. The Mughal Empire, which was dominated Indian subcontinent for two centuries, began to decline with internal and external pressures. So several Mughal emperors were killed, often after only briefly occupying the throne. So students, this is all about your chapter. I hope you have understood the chapter. Thank you very much.